I'm Sam Naney with Cascade Endurance, and today we're going to talk about the technique of moose hoofing, which is a step in the progression of ski-specific movements that you can do in the dryland season to prepare for winter ski mountaineering or Nordic ski racing or anything on skis where you have a gripping surface, whether it be skins or wax. So moose hoofing employs a little bit higher intensity than ski walking, and if you haven't learned about ski walking, check out our other video on that technique. But moose hoofing is a little bit more like a running stride, where it's more dynamic. There's a point at which both feet are off the ground, and it'd be the sort of technique that would be useful for workouts such as tempo or threshold uphill, where you might be doing several repeats of 10 to 15 minutes. So it's still moderate but higher intensity than ski walking. So again, just like with ski walking, it's useful to employ poles. These are some Nordic ski poles that I've cut to where they sit at about 90 degree elbow bend. And the way you want to think about moose hoofing is you can start by thinking about running uphill with a quick cadence and staying really tall. But the difference here is that with moose hoofing, you're working more off of a flat foot. And the reason being that we want to think about springing off of a loaded ski, whether that be a ski with a skin, in the case of backcountry or ski-mo, or a ski with kick wax, if it's Nordic ski. So it doesn't employ the same sort of forefoot strike and then hip extension the way that running does. With moose hoofing, you're gonna strike more on the flat of the foot and spring off of that as well, just as if you were springing off of the loaded ski that's sticking with the skin or with the wax. So again, a little bit more dynamic, but flat of the foot. And you wanna think about having a little bit of pop. Just pop right off the foot. So it's gonna look something like this. Intensity isn't too high, you're not full-on bounding yet, but it's more dynamic than ski walking. And so if we want to look at the progression between ski walking and moose hoofing, it's going to look like this. I'll start with ski walking and then go to moose hoofing. Ski walking, reaching the foot, and then I'm going to go to moose hoofing,